Hi you guys, welcome to another What I Eat in a Day video. I hope you guys are doing well today. I thought I would come out here and start the video and show you what I'm eating for breakfast. This has been pretty typical for me lately. I've been having a lot of fruit, specifically for breakfast, either in the form of whole fruit or smoothies. And today is just a really weird day with the kids already because we had to drop off the car at the shop. And the thing is, it's only 11 right now and both kids are taking a nap. So it's totally weird. They normally don't take a nap till way later, but I'm embracing it and I'm enjoying my late breakfast here by myself. And I wanted to take a minute to talk about, you know, having a mono meal. A mono meal is a wonderful way to kind of break fast after you've been fasting all night, sleeping and not eating or drinking anything. I used to eat mono meals all of the time. They're really easy on the digestion. They're a great way to just let your body, you know, have a little bit of a rest while still eating food. So it's definitely something to try out, even if you did it just for breakfast and you wanted to implement that into your day. It's a wonderful way to start the day, I think. I love doing it with melon because melon, you know, digests really quick and you want to eat melon away from other foods because it digests so quickly. And so doing watermelon or cantaloupe or any kind of melon that you have in your area that's in season, what a lovely hydrating way to start the day. And it also got me thinking, like, you know, when you're trying to lose weight and you're always in like those different stages of losing weight. And like when you first start out, it feels hard and it feels like you need to use all of your willpower and all of your self-discipline. And how am I ever going to lose this weight? Introducing some mono meals, maybe after you've had a night where you've eaten too much food or, you know, you've eaten, you know, outside of your plan or what you said you were gonna do. It's a great way to just start the day off without beating yourself up, without, you know, being like, oh, I gotta eat nothing now. This is just a great way to start the day, get you back on track for a good day of eating well, hydrating your body. So mono meals are something that I incorporate a lot. I will leave a video linked up here. It's a really old video where I talk a little bit more about mono meals. If you guys are interested, you can have some more information on that. Like I said, the kids are both asleep right now. What is going on? What world am I in? So I think what I might just do is get a jump start on prepping my other meals, and I'm gonna use a base of a sauce for both my lunch and dinner, and I'm gonna use that base to create two different versatile kind of sauces for my lunch and my dinner. So I'll share a little bit later the recipes that I've been developing, and I think that you're gonna enjoy them. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe and like. I'm gonna go ahead and finish up this mono meal out here in the sunshine, so I'll catch up with you guys at lunch in a little bit. Okay, so it is lunchtime and I told you I was gonna be making something that I don't typically use, but lately I've been making a lot of recipes with, ta-da, jackfruit. Now, jackfruit is an ingredient that I have dismissed for years. I never really, didn't sound interesting to me to make anything savory out of jackfruit. And I was really wrong. This is a great thing to kind of start to play with in the kitchen. It's really low in calories. It is fruit. This one right here I got at Trader Joe's, and it's just in brine, so there's no oil or anything like that. And I've been making a lot of recipes with jackfruit, and gosh, it's actually really great. It really has that kind of meaty consistency, if that's something that you're missing. Low calorie density within one of the categories of the lowest calorie density foods out there, and season it however you like, and it really takes on quite a bit of flavor and taste. So if you're bored of things like tempeh or tofu, it's actually a great alternative. I've made barbecue pulled pork sandwiches. I've done some jackfruit burritos lately, and like, these things taste really good. What I'm gonna make for lunch is a big salad, surprise, surprise. And I'm going to do a spicy jackfruit topping, and I wanna do a cilantro lime creamy dressing. I think everything's gonna go together very well. So let's go ahead and get into this spicy jackfruit salad-y kind of meal. First up, I'm just draining, seeding, and shredding the jackfruit. And then I'm just putting together my seasoning that I'm going to put on top of the jackfruit. I'm using liquid smoke, lime juice, some vegetable broth, maple syrup, a little bit of cumin, smoked paprika, tomato paste, and I am putting this in a medium frying pan and just sauteing it around. I've kind of tested out here as I was going, but the final full recipe will be linked down in the description. And then I'm sauteing the jackfruit for about 5 to 7 minutes. Chop chopping up really simple salad. I used a couple heads of romaine and some tomatoes and red onion and corn. Now I'm just blending some cashews and water, really plain. I'm taking half of that and reserving it for later. And the other half, I'm making a creamy cilantro dressing. And the half I will use now will have garlic powder, some water, cilantro, jalapeno, garlic, and lime. Look at that color, absolutely gorge.
The years only steal us.
Oh, this looks so beautiful. This is absolutely my kind of meal. This dressing turned out amazing. You guys will really enjoy it. So, so yummy. All right, let's give a taste test. This is exactly the kind of thing I like to eat. Mexican food and just very light and very low in calorie density. Let's give it a taste. That dressing is amazing. And you can see I didn't use a lot. If you need like more dressing in your salad and you're trying to lose weight, I would suggest just putting extra lime juice on here. But the kind of creaminess of this, it's really good and salty with just a little tiny kick, and the sweetness of the jackfruit together, so, so good. I really enjoy this. So I'm gonna go ahead and enjoy this lovely salad. I feel like this could serve probably 2 or 3 people, but I'm gonna eat it all by myself. So excuse me while I do that, and I'll see you guys at dinner. All right, it's dinner time, and I'm going to just make a really comforting, quick meal of some dill potatoes with some crispy chickpeas that have been roasted in the oven. Those have really been what I've been wanting lately. I've got another recipe that I'm gonna share in an upcoming video that is so, so good, but beside the point. I'm gonna do some dill potatoes with some chickpeas, probably a raw salad if I know myself, and I do. And I'm gonna make a dressing out of that base dressing I made earlier. So I've got 2 meals out of the one time that I made the dressing, and it's probably gonna stretch even farther, and I'll have it for other meals throughout the week. So let's go ahead and get this going. It's really simple. It's just throwing everything into a pan and then adding some greens. So definitely very simple, and definitely the way that I like to eat pretty regularly. So let's get into dinner. I'm preheating the oven to 400 Fahrenheit and then lining a baking sheet with parchment paper. And I'm prepping my chickpeas with apple cider vinegar, garlic powder, dried dill, and fresh parsley, and a little bit of salt and pepper. Baby. Chopping up my potato wedges. And on half of the baking pan, I'm gonna put the chickpeas, and on the other half, I'm just going to place the potato wedges. I've seen many pretty faces. You're the only one we're chasing. Think I may be falling in love. I've been getting into you. Garnishing with fresh parsley on everything, a little bit of paprika, salt on the potatoes. Thinking about you got me losing my sanity. Then pop that in the oven for about 45 minutes. To make the dressing, I'm using that cashew cream that I reserved from before. I'm adding in some chives, dill, water, and a little bit of lemon juice. Salt and pepper to taste, and then assemble your bowl with tons of greens, the potatoes, and the chickpeas on top. Can't help but stare. You know nobody else can take me there. These other ladies, I
I really love the clothes you wear. Obsessed about the curls up in your hair. It drives me crazy.
I could literally eat something like this every single day. Just some really simple potato or sweet potato along with the chickpeas. And this dressing came out really beautifully. And then I've got some leftovers, which I'll probably eat also. So let's give it a taste test. All right, here we go. I'm not getting anything on the fork. Literally nothing. If you're gonna make them this big, just eat them with your hands. Delish. Enjoy. Really good. All right, you guys, so those are the recipes for today. The recipes will be linked down in the description below. And these are things that I've been really enjoying making lately, and I think that you will like them too. Very simple, but also very comforting and still taste really, really good. That is absolutely my jam. Make it low calorie density, make it taste good, and still not regret your choices. I wanted to let you guys know I'll be going live next Sunday. And so I want you to tune in. It's gonna be a Q&A. We can talk more about weight loss if you want, or anything that you might have on your mind that I can help you out with or give you some answers to. So thank you so much for watching. Make sure that you give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and go ahead and share it with somebody who needs some recipes in their life. I hope you guys have a wonderful week, and I will see you live next Sunday. Bye.
Think I may be falling.